music is one of the fine arts. It is God-given gift to humanity. All living beings enjoy music. Shishur veti pashur veti, veti ganera sampanihi. But man is capable of giving expression to it. Music gives solace and happiness to both performers and listeners. Life is not complete without fine arts, for its emotional expression with tranquility. Music maintains its novelty and nonchality with musicians. Singers can sing to their last breath. At the same time, even performers on various musical instruments are able to play their instruments, maintaining a good mental health. Music makes one healthy, provided he or she maintains good habits, culture and discipline, concentration, memory, grasping power, managing different tasks, relaxation, realization of soul, knowledge of various subjects, different languages, sacred lores, including science, humanities are possible with learning of music. It provides relaxed mind and encourages to execute more jobs, learn more subjects with lesser strain. Practicing and listening to music is a good exercise for controlling hypertension, heart and lungs. Breathing exercises are automatically done through music and increases the brain cells by activating them. Indian music had its origin from Vedas. The contribution of many, especially Vagyekaras, that is, composers, Lakshanikas, that is, theorists, performing musicians, teachers, students and listeners called Bahushrutas are immeasurable. Karnataka Sangeeta refers to a very old and well-established system of South classical music branched out of Indian music. Karnataka Sangeeta took shape during the period of 15th century as Venkatamakin framed 72 Melakarta ragas, which are the mother ragas. Sri Purandaradasa and many eminent composers devoted their life to music and composed varieties of Urupadis. From there, the systematic method of Carnatic music started. Karnataka Sangeeta Pitamaha Sri Purandaradasa was hailed as the father of music. He composed elementary lessons called the Abhyasa Gana, namely Swaravalis, Geetas and Kirtana in Kannada and Sanskrit. New Tala system called Suladi Sapta Tala, Chapu Tala were devised by Haridasas and Talapaka Mannamacharya. About 101 ragas were devised. They are the reformers and revolutionaries who could change the well-established prabandhas, compositional forms which had an history of 1000 years. Regional languages established in the compositions with a new format. Thus, a good history is seen during the period of 15th century in the field of Indian music. Karnataka music was enriched by the Trinity. Tyagaraja, Muthuswami Dikshita and Shyama Shastri. Their period is considered as the golden age of Karnataka Sangeeta. Vagyekara, earlier to Trinity and after, contributed a variety of compositional forms and changed new ragas, thus enriched the repertoire of Carnatic music. Teaching of music is as important as performing. To pass on the tradition, it is very important to carry over the legacy of our past masters. Classical music is devised on a firm foundation based on the scientific principles rendered artistically. Known few and unknown many have contributed to the progress of Karnataka Sangeeta. Music teachers have a greater role. They should be well equipped with varieties of compositions, ragas, intricacies of talas, with a good background of theory. Vocalists should know the technique of cultivating good voice, and instrumentalists should be proficient in the technique of playing their respective instruments. Mode of teaching of music in Gurukula was predominant. Students lived in the musical environment, listening to a single style. At present, this system cannot be expected, as more and more girls are taking to music and boys are doing professional courses. Under these circumstances, there is a question for good teachers. They are nowadays available only in certain cities. Shortage of time and long distances make the eager student disheartened to pursue music studies. Only a few are fortunate to have musical atmosphere at home, which helps them to acquire good music and they can easily take up music as a profession. But those who love music and want to pursue music knowledge need not be disappointed. It is always believed by great scientists, philosophers, professors and researchers that studies made at the background of classical music increases their capacity of learning. At the same time, those who work restlessly for hours together need some relaxation. This can be contributed by learning of music. That could be done during their leisure time. This gives relief to their monotonous daily course. Voice culture. All singers are not fortunate to possess a good voice. As age advances, quality of the voice decreases. Usually, teaching of music affects the strength of voice. Rendering in higher pitch or octave becomes difficult. Only a few of the performers possess a good melodious voice. Singing on each swara by holding the breath, that is, resting on each swara, improves the strength of the voice. With perfect swarasthana and perfect rhythm, rendering swara and akara in three speeds improves the voice. This is the foundation for the future alapana and swara kalpana. Using the YouTube channels and recorded means would enable the students to learn without any struggle. In olden days, people used to teach them through tape recorders, CD players and DVD players. Only listening to music would imbibe them into this world. They start singing without their own knowledge, which is a musical magic. But learning of music, especially classical music, is not easy without a teacher. Those who are busy and are not able to spend time, they can depend on YouTube channels and online classes. Even during their journey time, they can listen to those recorded music from various means. If they regularize this, they can learn classical music in no time. Basic lessons of classical music are needed for even those who are interested in light music, film music, folk music and orchestras. As all these need accuracy in swarasthana or knowledge of rhythm. Physically handicapped, blind, etc. can also learn through these recorded forms as they only need their ears to work. These technological and online forms also enable students from a small age of even 6 to learn music in a systematic way. Even housewives who could not expose their talent in their small ages could listen to these recorded forms and start learning music while their daily chores. Thus, their desire is fulfilled and their work is even done. You can imbibe these lessons, that is, Abhyasa Ganas, Geetas, Kirtanas, performances, Western music, say keyboard, etc. Even Mridangam, that shows the tradition of our country. Shlokas, bhajans, available with some cine songs in saxophone at our music channel called Classroom Music. Never miss this opportunity. Do acquire it from our channel. We are here to spread the wisdom of music. Thank you. Subscribe, share, like.